Hello everyone, welcome to the third lecture on mutation. As you know that in last lecture, that was the second lecture on mutation, we have seen about the structure of nucleotide, and we were discussing about the components of nucleotide, what are different components. And as we know, what are the different components or three components of a nucleotide? The first one we saw, that is phosphate, second one sugar, and third one that is base. We have seen about a simple structure of phosphate, then we discussed about the structure of sugar, that is pentose sugar, and the difference in DNA and RNA. And today we will discuss about the base or nitrogenous bases. What is a base, what different types of base we have in DNA and RNA. In short, let's see about the differences, or we can compare the structural features of sugar in DNA and RNA. As we saw about the sugars, sugar in case of DNA and RNA, if we remember the structure, now this is the structure of sugar in case of RNA. If we see about the structure, we have the similar structure. In case of DNA, so what is the difference in DNA? We have no oxygen at carbon number 2. How we number? This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, and 5. Here also carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And that's why this is pentose sugar. Now, why do we call these two are nucleic acids? Why I call this one as RNA and why I call this as DNA? It is ribonucleic acid. Why? Because I have a ribose sugar. Now I call it as deoxyribonucleic acid. Why? Because here, as we saw, that O is missing over here, and that's why accordingly we call this nucleic acid as DNA, that means deoxyribonucleic acid. So this was about the sugar. Now we will see about the bases. Now, if we talk about bases or nitrogenous bases, how to define a base? What is a base? It is a compound that is cyclic, or it has a ring structure. It is cyclic, and it is having a ring structure. And since it contains nitrogen along with the carbon in the skeleton or the framework, and that's why I call it as nitrogenous base. So this is how we can define a base, or this is how we can define a nitrogenous base. So this is how the definition, or this is how we can define in simple language. Now about the structure and types. If we see about the types of bases or nitrogenous bases that are typically found in DNA and RNA, we have, for example, if we study about DNA, we have four different kinds of bases. These are adenine, then we have guanine, then we have cytosine, and then we have the fourth one, that is thymine. We have another one that is uracil, that is specifically present in RNA instead of thymine. So that we will discuss afterwards. Now these are the four bases that we have, or that we have in the nucleic acids. So if we talk about the DNA, now we can have these four different kinds of nitrogenous bases. One by one we will discuss, and a simple structure. Since this we are discussing, these structures we are discussing under the topic mutation, so please make it a point that we will not go at much deeper level or molecular level about the DNA or anything whatever we are discussing. Whatever is required for understanding mutation, that part only we are discussing. In different lecture, when I will discuss separately about the DNA or nucleic acid, there I will discuss in detail at the molecular level. So whatever is required over here for understanding mutation or different types of mutation, we will discuss that part only. So please make it a point. So these are four different types: adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine, and we have uracil in RNA. Now adenine and guanine, if we talk about, these are the purines, and if we talk about the cytosine, thymine and uracil, these are the pyrimidines. So one by one we will discuss about the purines and pyrimidines. So first thing we will discuss, that is about the purines, that is adenine and guanine. So first thing about the purines, a few simple points to understand the concept of what is a purine, what is a typical simple structure of purine. This is, since it is a base, it is also a cyclic compound that will have nitrogen, and that's why we call it as nitrogenous base. Now it is having a double ring structure. That means I will have one ring, along with it I will have another. So this is your double ring structure. It's very clear. That means I will have, if I say what are the purines, I have the adenine, and second one I have the guanine. If I say these two are the purine, that means what kind of structure they will have? Both adenine and guanine, they will have double ring structure. So what are differences? Obviously there are certain differences. What are the differences? If we talk about first one, that is adenine, since as I just told you, that is a double ring structure. How to draw the structure? Now this is the structure of adenine. And how we number it, or the number of atoms over here, we will start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we have 7, 8, and 9. This is how we number. Please make it a point that, as I told you, why we call this as nitrogenous base, because along with the carbon, what we have nitrogen, and that's why we call it as nitrogenous base. So this is not the detailed structure of adenine, but whatever is required for understanding about mutation that we are discussing. Now, what is important to note in adenine, that is at number 1 and at number 6. Now, this is very important for understanding mutation. This you will understand when we will discuss about the mutation or kinds of mutation. So you have to remember the structure typically at number 1 and at number 6. Now the structure of guanine. It will also have a very similar structure with some differences. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if we talk about the atoms, here we have nitrogen, here we'll have carbon, 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 then we'll have nitrogen, carbon. Now this is the structure again, the point, what we have to note over here, since we are discussing about the mutation, again, we have to be very specific about these two points, that is at number 1, at number 6. Is it very clear? So this is the structure of guanine. So these two are the purines that are the part of nucleotide. Next one we will discuss about the pyrimidines. As compared to the purines, pyrimidines, they have simple structure. First one we will discuss, that is cytosine, and second one we can discuss, that is thymine. Simple structure, we have just one ring, that means if we talk about the pyrimidines, they have just one ring. How do we number? We have the groups attached over here, and we number from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is the structure. Again, the point that we have to note over here, because when we study about the mutation kinds, this will be very important to see. Again, we have to see the importance at number 3 and number 4. So this is the structure of your cytosine. If we talk about thymine, very similar structure. Again, we will have the numbering. Now this is the structure of your thymine, and this is the important point that we have to note in mutation. So these are the different bases. We have seen about the structure, that is the purines, that is adenine and guanine, and then we have the pyrimidines that have just one ring structure, as you can see over here. They are the cytosine and thymine. Now these are four different kinds of bases. We are not discussing about uracil, that is the part of RNA. So these are different kinds of bases, four different kinds of bases. Now we have discussed what is phosphate, what kind of sugar we have, that is pentose, ribose, deoxyribose, and we have the third component, that is the base. So I hope whatever we have discussed today, that is very clear. And since you already know, now we have discussed that what are the components, and one thing you can note that in a nucleotide, if I say that I have three components, I have, if I say in a nucleotide, in a nucleotide, if I say I have three components, the first one is phosphate, second one is sugar, and third one is nitrogenous base. That means if I talk about DNA, this will be common for all the nucleotides. These are the nucleotides. That means I will have phosphate, one type, one common. I will have sugars, okay, that is also common. Now where the difference will come, because we have four different types of bases, and that's why accordingly I can have four different types of nucleotides in case of DNA, and accordingly I can have the name of the nucleotide. I hope whatever we have discussed, that is very clear to you along with the structure. Again, I'm telling you, we are not discussing much in detail about the structures of any base, cytosine, thymine, adenine, or guanine. The point is why? Because we are discussing about mutation. So make it very clear, whatever is required, that part is only being discussed over here. So please go through the video, see it, and try to understand it. In next lecture, I will try to explain something about that, what different kinds of nucleotide we can have in a DNA or in RNA molecule. And after that, we will continue with the mutation part, and we will start in proper about the gene mutation. And further, we will discuss about the types of mutation. I hope everything is very clear. Whatever you feel like, you can comment in the comment section. And thank you for watching the video.